Let's play with Napoleon.
Hasn't anyone ever told you not to fall asleep with a lit cigarette? You could start a fire. So, are you gonna invite me in? Or what?
I love giving rides to strange drifters. Hop in.
Thanks. Damn, you've been busy.
It's nothing. Just some junk I found lying around.
A rainbow towel? A freaky red light? That is dark.
Too dark?
Perfect dark. Chloe, this is incredible. I can't believe you found us an escape vehicle already.
That's the hope. But it doesn't exactly drive yet.
You'll figure it out. And while you're at it, we're also gonna need some money. You know, to buy stuff.
Uh-huh. Car and money? Anything else you'd like?
Luckily, there's no rush.
True. And no Blackwell.
Holy shit. That Wells meeting. I'm so sorry. I can't believe he actually expelled you.
Why not? No reason to prolong the inevitable.
It's definitely Blackwell's loss. You covering for me was amazing. I don't know how to thank you.
Whatever. You tried to cover for me, too.
Tried and failed. I guess we know who the better liar is.
Or maybe my lie was the one he wanted to believe.
At least Wells has no idea what really went down with us last night. Shit got pretty wild.
Rachel, that was more than pretty wild. You went absolutely nuts last night. What the hell were you thinking?
I was angry. I didn't expect the whole stupid park to go whoosh. But now you're in on it too. Accessory after the fact. Unless you tell on me, of course.
I'm no snitch. I'd be way happier going to jail than having to live at home with Dictator David. He announced his plans to move in this morning.
Oh, Chloe, that's awful. I'm so sorry. You know what we both could use? Therapy.
Therapy.
You start. Kick back and tell me what's bothering you.
Well, Doc. I've been booted from school, and I'm not entirely sure what to do about it.
You mean how to cope with your feelings of anger and disappointment?
No. I mean how to express my feelings of intense joy.
Uh-huh. Do you think you might be taking this a little too well?
You tell me. I'd say I'm exceptionally well-adjusted.
I'd bet my therapist's license that no one's ever called you that before.
Touché, Doc. There's this dildo with a mustache who's been dating my mom, and now he thinks he's moving in with us. How do I stop him?
That's a hard one. I'm not sure there's really anything you can do.
Then what the hell am I talking to you for?
Just because you can't stop him doesn't mean you don't fight back. The resistance begins now. All right. You're going to need a new nickname to mark your enemy. What have you got?
He's a step douche, because he's inserting himself where he doesn't belong. Also, he's a douche.
Poetic. May I also suggest stepladder?
Why stepladder?
Because he climbs on your mom every night.
Ew!
And pretty soon, they'll be stepping down the aisle.
What the hell kind of therapist are you?
Sorry. It's called shock therapy. Highly controversial.
So, my new friend, who everyone thinks is perfect, did something batshit fucking nutso last night. What do I do?
This perfect friend of yours, who I'm assuming is also an exceptional beauty, sounds like she may have been inspired by someone new in her life. Someone who is also, may I add, a knockout in the looks department. Perhaps this friend of yours, who, I reiterate, must be just stunning, needed someone in her life to teach her.
How to steal wine from yuppie picnickers?
How not to give a fuck. Because she was tired of having to give so many fucks all the time.
That makes sense. That was actually somewhat therapeutic. Thank you.
It's always a pleasure delving into the mind of Chloe Price.
And now it's your turn. Tell me all about what it's like being daughter of Arcadia Bay's most famous scumbag.
It sucks.
Too blunt? Sorry. I do that sometimes.
Nah, I'm just... I don't know. Can we talk about something else?
Of course. Hey, chances are, pretty soon this entire town will be burnt to a smoldering pile of ashes, so, you know, things are really looking up for us.
From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. Do you think there's a point when you've been acting so much that you don't even have your own personality anymore? You're just whatever you think other people want you to be.
I think you have a personality.
I wasn't talking about me. My dad doesn't really exist. You saw him in Wells' office. The whole thing is a performance. And now I'm starting to feel like everything in my life is bullshit. But he's still my dad. How can I make sure I don't end up like him?
You couldn't be like him even if you wanted to. You're too awesome.
The fact that you believe that makes me feel better. Shit. It's time for the play. As if my life didn't have enough drama in it.
Good luck.
You know you're never supposed to tell an actor good luck before a show? It's bad luck.
How is telling someone good luck bad luck?
You're supposed to say, break a leg.
That's dumb.
Hey, I was thinking that after the show, maybe we could go do something. Just you and me.
Something criminal?
Criminally fun.
I'm in. Wait, you forgot your bag.
It's for you. Just a little survival kit for your new life on the lam. Drive safe, Chloe.
Hello, Junk Shack. Time to check out Rachel Amber's mystery bag. A bag full of clothes. Yes, I need those. Nothing like an abandoned shack in the middle of a junkyard to make a girl feel like exploring a new wardrobe. Cutting edge in junkyard security technology. That's the woman we saw with Rachel's dad. Weird.
Yo, Frank! It's Chloe. I don't know the secret password, man. Is the password drugs?
Price, get your ass in here.
Dude, it smells like piss in here.
Shut up.
You have a rough night or something?
Every night's a rough night. I've got a notebook in the back somewhere. Go get it for me, would you?
Who was that one? Ah! God. Jeez, man.
Get my notebook, Price. Then we'll talk.
Things for Frank. How low can I go?
And we're back. You're listening to
a betting slip. $1,200? Way out of my league.
I'm gonna cut right to the chase, Jack. What can you tell us?
So Frank's a fellow survivor of Black Hell.
Alright. Big,
hard
to contain. We don't typically see fires like this on the
earth. What does Frank really need to remember?
But that could change at any second.
Got it.
Gonna have to prepare to evacuate the next few days.
I don't think it'll come to that. Well, the fire is spreading in an unusual way, sort of surrounding the northern part of Arcadia Bay, but not advancing toward it.
Bomb sauce for the man who enjoys searing pain with his drive-through order. Wonder what Frank eats when he gets the munchies.
Thanks for filling us in, Jack.
You're welcome. Been a pleasure.
That's an insane amount of beans. Apparently, Frank is a werewolf. A balanced breakfast. I guess Frank subscribes to the hiding in plain sight philosophy of drug stashing. Do I really want to see Frank's bedroom? Okay, little guy.
Aw, shit! Pompidou, get up here!
Pompidou?
You little killer.
Swingy, flippy instrument of death. That's probably the notebook Frank wants. A throne fit for Frank. Someone's a messy eater. Frank and his BFF. That's adorable. Is this what I think it is? Ugh, shit. I'm in the red. Time to find out what Frank wants to discuss. That dog makes Frank look almost nice. Is this it?
Have a seat.
Pompidou, huh? That's one badass name for a dog.
It's French.
Does it mean, like, tough guy or something?
Do I look like I speak fucking French?
Okay, so who was that woman?
What woman?
The one I saw coming out of your RV?
Oh yeah, I meant to introduce you. Her name is Mind Your Own Fucking Business.
Rachel would want to know more. I bet I can convince Frank it's harmless to tell me. Dude, I'm just curious. What's the big deal?
Idiot. I make money by being discreet.
Frank, you know I hate everyone. Who do you think I'm gonna tell?
Come on, Price, I gotta protect my clients. Happy customers are the foundation of a good business.
Your customers like you because you're laid back. That's why I like you. So you should keep building up that easygoing vibe, you know?
Sure, I guess. So why are you so hung up on this chick?
I'm not. Just hanging with a friend here. A friend I don't know much about. Tell me, Frank. Seeing any girls lately?
I don't know.
Frank. Talk. And I'll get my mom to make you something special.
Like what? How about that firehouse chili of hers?
You got it.
The woman you saw. Her name's Sarah. Showed up a few weeks ago, causing all kinds of trouble for all sorts of people.
Like who?
It's a little out of your league, okay?
But what kind of trouble, exactly?
Forget about it, Chloe. Shouldn't have opened my mouth.
Thanks for telling me.
Whatever. You hear the mill burn down?
Shit! Really?
Crazy. My friend Damon runs the place. He lost a lot of money last night.
How about you? Did you lose anything in the fire?
No. But I'll probably get pulled into whatever shit Damon's dealing with right now. Lately, he's been doing some stuff that I don't like. But I don't seem to have much leverage with him like I once had. Anyway, you and I have shit to discuss.
Is this about the buck 75?
What?
The money that I owe you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, I don't give a shit about that. Wait, do you have it?
Give me like another week. I don't have enough right now.
I wonder if I'll ever get tired of your crap. You're lucky you're the least of my problems. Open my notebook. Last page. Should be some entries for a kid named Drew. You know him?
Drew North? Yeah, he's... Oh, holy shit. That's a lot of money.
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Apparently football players eat it like candy.
That's smart, I guess. It pays well?
Go Bigfoots. Problem is, Drew owes a grant, and he's not answering my calls. You know what's going on with them?
No, I never talked to him. Or his type.
No one's just a type, Price. Anyway, here's the job. I'm taking you to Blackwell. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up. Can you handle that?
Yeah. Of course, but what's in it for me?
Idiot, you still owe me.
So, if I do this, then we're good?
That, and I'll do even better. I'll give you a 10% cut of the money.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll do it.
What's the matter?
It might be a little tough. I'm not supposed to be at Blackwell. I got expelled this morning.
Congratulations. Still easier for you to go on campus than for me. If you can't even do this, Price.
$100 closer to leaving Arcadia Bay. With a bit of cash and the truck fixed,
Rachel and I could really do it. We could leave for good. I'll do it.
Good deal.
Think I'd be back this soon. Well, here goes nothing. Better hurry up and get into the dorms. What would I buy if I had enough money to build a whole dorm? Probably not a dorm. A new medium? Welcome to hell. Max would have jumped on that photographer position. What are the chances that 200 years ago, some teenager got in trouble for carving faces all over the thing?
Come on.
There's Evan, putting his pretentious art above his sanity, as usual. In a way, that's kind of badass.
What are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be at home, thinking over your endless list of questionable decisions?
Dude, why do you care about my questionable decisions?
It offends me when intelligence is wasted.
Did Evan just call me intelligent? Damn straight. Wow. Evan looks really ridiculous.
Chloe?
Uh-huh.
I've learned something about myself recently. Something that I think you might understand. I've learned that if I'm passionate about something, it's probably the right thing to care about. Forest fires, for example. You were the only person who signed my petition. I mean, seriously signed it.
That's pretty sad. I'm a low bar, but... did you really expect people to care?
People are so eager to pass on responsibility to anyone else so that they can live comfortable, unworried, and ultimately meaningless lives. You see what happened?
Looks like you were right. Go, Evan. You're a hero of the people.
I know you feel like I do. About different things, I'm sure. But you only give a shit about what you give a shit about. I like that. Anyway, you're not supposed to be here. You should leave.
Blackwell Academy. Conserving water since... never. Evan's subject for the day. Better you than me, Bird. That's some intellectual shit, Samuel. Nice work, Samuel. Samuel. Blackwell's resident creepy groundskeeper. Hey, Samuel. Keeping busy?
Always, Chloe Price. I didn't think you'd be returning to these hallowed halls so soon.
Neither did I.
I have the feeling it wasn't the books or bricks of Blackwell that led you back.
What?
You're here for someone. A special someone, yes?
What do you think of Rachel Amber?
Rachel Amber is a dragon made of diamonds.
That's, deep. Do you just make this shit up on the fly, or do you, like, write it down beforehand?
Are you angry all the time because you like the way it feels? Or is it merely a desperate defense against experiencing true intimacy with others?
I'm, looking for Drew North.
Most look at Drew North and see only the athlete, but he is more than that.
He is?
A great heart he has, with much love and no room for fear.
I've always thought he was kind of a bully.
He may be that, too. No one is just one thing.
So... what about Elliot Hampton? Have you seen him recently?
I only see what Elliot wants me to see.
Okay.
Usually I can see both what people want me to see and what they want to keep hidden.
And, what do I want to keep hidden?
That you are lonely and afraid. It's okay not to be okay, Chloe Price.
I've gotta go, man. It's been real.
I often wonder what real is. Farewell, Chloe Price.
Evan's subject for the day. Better you than me, Bird. Now that I'm gone, Steph might be the coolest person left at Blackwell. Besides Rachel, obviously. Hey, Steph.
Whoa. Hey, Calamastia. Your shirt looks like the tea leaves they used to tell people's fortunes.
How's my future looking?
Bright and sunny.
Surprised to see me on parole?
I told you Wells was out to get you. That text was a rare courtesy, by the way. I don't normally get involved in other people's dumb decisions.
Thanks for trying, but skipping yesterday was totally worth it.
skipping with Rachel Amber does have an appeal.
Well, yeah.
So, what are you doing here?
I figured I'd see the Tempest.
For real? You?
Yeah, I know. It's not really my thing. Kinda hoping it's a shit show.
What the hell? I'm the stage manager.
Oh, I think I knew that. My bad.
You better mean it. Honestly, the show's really good. It's worth seeing.
I'm sure it is.
Obviously, Rachel's fantastic, but everyone else is pretty impressive, too. You get to see a totally different side of everyone, especially the guys.
Okay. I'm intrigued. Go on.
Like, Hayden's so annoying, but when he puts on that crown, he's actually very princely. And Nathan as Caliban? There's so much depth there.
Right. Depth. Yeah, well, good luck with all of that. Maybe I'll see you later.
Oh, hey. I wanted to ask you something.
Shoot.
I've been planning to make a move on Rachel, but not if you two were together.
Make a move?
So, are you? I mean, that's Rachel's business. Or maybe yours and Rachel's business. But if you feel comfortable telling me...
You think we're... together?
It looks to me like you've got a thing for her and maybe she has a thing for you. And I wouldn't want to get in the way.
I'm... I don't know. It's confusing.
Yeah, I can imagine. You ever want to talk to me, Chloe, you know you can, right?
I'll see you later, Steph.
Have fun storming the castle.
Steph's probably biased, but she does have taste. Maybe the show will be good. Locked. Figures. Looks like my options are become a master lockpicker or swipe someone's keys. Bingo. If only those keys were unsupervised. What's Samuel working on? The sprinklers? If Samuel's working on the sprinklers, some damage here might get his attention. But Evan is right there.
Hey!
Shit. I wanted you to go the other way. Like, as far as possible, the other way. Time for a fresh start. Here we go. One small flight for this bird, one giant leap backward for Chloe Price.
Come on.
If I can scare that bird far enough away, maybe Evan won't see me break that sprinkler. Almost there. Gotcha.
Oh, perfect.
You're welcome.
Awesome. Now I just have to wait for Samuel to turn on the... That works. Sorry, Samuel. All right, time to find Drew's room. No time like the present.
Chloe?
Hey, Skip. How's it going?
Not that it isn't great to see you and all, but what are you doing here? Didn't you just get expelled?
Relax. I'm just visiting a friend.
I really can't just let you go in.
I'm going inside, dude. You're just gonna have to let this slide.
I don't think I can. In fact, I think I have to ask you to state your official business or else vacate Blackwell property.
I hate to do this to Skip, but I've got to get inside. Maybe if I make him really uncomfortable, he'll feel guilty and let me pass. What's my official business? Women's business, Skip. As in, my uterus? I need to use the restroom. Glad you asked.
What? No. No, it's my job to ask, Chloe.
If you keep violating students' personal rights, you're going to get fired.
It's not like that. Do you know what Wells would do to me if I didn't, you know, patrol?
You know Wells doesn't really respect you, right? You're just a rent-a-cop who needs a haircut.
I thought we were friends. Where is this coming from?
I thought we were friends too, but... When the man comes down on you, you come down on me. Is that it?
Look, look, look! I'm really sorry, Chloe. I'm just so confused right now.
Just look the other way, Skip. It's not like I'm up to anything criminal. I just need to use the bathroom.
I don't know what to do.
Seriously, my uterus is on fire, dude.
What?
Is that, descriptive enough?
I don't want to know about...
En fuego utero, Skip. En fuego utero.
I don't know what to say. I'm so sorry.
Matthews.
Huh? I'm here?
I've gotten reports of an unknown vehicle in the parking lot.
Oh, thank God. Oh, I'm on it.
I won't tell Wells. Do what you have to do, okay? I won't tell anyone.
All right, which one is Drew's room? Could Elliot be lamer if he tried? Elliot does work really hard. I guess I'm happy for him. I knew Elliot did well in class, but I didn't realize he was here on a full ride. I've never been able to get Elliot to play for me. I guess he's either really good or really bad. Wow. I remember this show. Crazy that Elliot would hold on to this picture after so long. Guess I'm not the only one who keeps a diary. That's not half bad. Okay. Dark. Who is it that Elliot's writing about? Elliot is way more artistic than I thought. Wait, are these about me? What the fuck, Elliot? Elliot's mom seems nice. Lucky Dana. Warren Graham is such a nerd. Huh. There's way less porn here than I would have thought. The world breaks everyone, and afterward, summer strong at the broken places. Why does that make me sad? Elliot's kind of preppy in his own way. Maybe he does belong at Blackwell. I want to say that half the fun of weed is knowing it's illegal, but I think it'd be just as awesome over the counter. That is really gross. I wonder what Max would think. Yep, definitely Drew's room. What do I do if Drew's here?